Hi.
In this video, we are going to talk about a vNode store and forward feature. Remember that this feature is part of the core of vNode platform, and it solves a basic and typically issue when we try to send information from one point to another endpoint. And in the middle, we must experience some data loss, some connection failures over the network. So Store&Forward, it's like a great solution to log information in the, like in a local environment during a network failure, and after the connection is recovery, the same information will be sent to a central application that will look for this information. And one thing that is very important to talk about is that the same information will update to the, in this case, central application with the same timestamp. So there is no data loss, actually. In this video, I have two virtual machines, actually. This is the one. This is the virtual machine number one. Right, this is, right now, this is my actual computer. And I have another VM that is here, okay? So first of all, to configure vNode Store&Forward feature, we need to know, in this case, that to do this, we must need to use two vNodes in this case, at least two vNodes. One will be acting as a remote application, and the other vNode will be acting as a central server that will take information. So the basic architecture will be that we have a first vNode that will have been taking data from an OPC server, as an example, or an PLC, whatever you need. And this data will be logging to a Mongo database that will be on a central server. In this case, in this central server, it will be vNode. So what we must need to do is to link the two vNodes between them. And once we cut the connection between both vNodes, it must log the information on the local server. After we reconnect the connection, we will see that the same data that have been lost during the time, it will be showing up on the vNode central, and it will fill the blanks on the chart or fill the blanks on the table or whatever you will see. And that's it. That's part of a big solution that, in this case, vNode Automation is offering to you. So first of all, here is my local server, actually, vNode local code. Okay. Under vNode local, actually, if you go to config, you must create a model that belongs to a historian. Remember that vNode has a lot of models, just to connect to OPC servers, to act as an MQTT client, and one of these models are a historian to log information to MongoDB, actually. So, if you go here under historian, you create a model, actually, like this. Here I'm my historian. I call, his name is historian, I type his name, actually. And the model type that you have to select is historian, okay? After that, click on save. And once it is created, it will be appear here. So you must select that the buffer limit will be like this, the insert rate, the max date to log the formation, 60 days, for example. And the embedded DB engine, it will be enabled because the, in this case, vNode has the feature also that has embedded a MongoDB under his platform. So, under his platform, okay? So, this is the TCP port that used Mongo to log information, okay? Click on save, and you already configured your historian model under local. This historian model will be logging information coming from the other vNode that will be remote, all right? So, let's switch to the other vNode. This is our vNode remote. So, what we must need to do, first of all, is to go and create a link. This link will reflect that this vNode will be sending information to the vNode local that we already configured, all right? So, under config, go to links, and under links, you must select or create a name to the link, all right? In this case, we'll call vNode remote, okay? In this case, remote, all right? Over tag subscription, it means that this vNode, if you select all, it will subscribe to any group of tags from other vNode, actually. But in this case, this vNode will act as a sender. So we just hit a none, tag subscription. And also in the connection to in, it will reflect that if this vNode will act as a receiver of data, you must enable the option to enable to true in this case, okay? But what we need to do actually is to select a connection for out. In this case, which means is you can send information to another vNode, okay? So hit on this button, create a new link. And under the new link, we are going to call as the same as appears in the vNode local, right? So go here on the vNode local, select links, and if you can see, his name is vNode local, okay? So we must type the same name. Okay, vNode local, all right? After that, select here, and you must set to true to enable, and the host, it will be the IP address from the vNode local, right? The IP address from the vNode local is 1131, all right? The same TCP IP port, and the most important thing is to set up the start and forward feature, which is means that once the data experience any network failure or the connection experience any network failure, this vNode will act as a buffer and will collect the same information and log it there. And once the information will be reconnected, this information will be sent to a local vNode with the same timestamp, all right? So, you set to true, also enable, and you can leave this the same parameters as default, that's not a problem, and hit and save, all right? Okay, so after we did this, we set it up the link from vNode local to vNode remote too. And we enable a store and forward feature, right? So the next step is to test if the connection between the both vNodes it's working well. So let's go to the other vNode, in this case, the vNode local. And under diagnostics, you will see under links that there is a connection already created from the endpoint for this IP address. This IP address belongs to a vNode remote too, and this is the port. And it says that the store forward is enabled and the status is online, actually, okay? So, if everything is okay, let's go back to the vNode remote, and let's see if we can create some tags. Actually, if we go to tags here, you go here and I already created a folder, okay, a group, and I create a tag coming from an OPC server too. All right, you can see here, there's my tag. We create a model for connection to OPCDA client. This is the model of the name, the model name, and we said here the tag coming from this path, actually. Okay, so the next step is to configure a history, which is means that this tag will be logging to a storage application, in this case MongoDB too. So under history, let's set enable to true, and the model name, which is means that which model will belongs to the historian. In this case, it will be referring to the historian created on vNode local. So if we go here, remember that we already create a historian, a model, which his name is historian actually, and we must type under this here, in this case, the name of the link, in this case, connection, backslash, and we must type the same name as the model created on vNode local, which is means historian, actually. So this will make that this data, this tag, will log into MongoDB that is already embedded on vNode local. Okay, so once we did this, let's hit on save. Okay, and how can we test if the link works well? So if we go back to, in this case, vNode local, if you go to real time to see if the test is working, you will see that the folder simulation that in this case was created on vNode remote will appear here in vNode local, and the data it's working well. We are looking the tag in real time mode actually, but if you go to historical data, we must see that the data will be logged into MongoDB. This historical feature that you see is like a interface to look data login under MongoDB embedded actually here. So we select the tag, this under the folder simulation, the group, we take temp, which is the name of the tag, and we select a date mode as a current query, and an interval of 1 hour. I don't know what you want to do, and it will be a raw query actually. Select apply, and you will see that if we can go back here, the data actually is logging here. If we go to show data, actually there is our table, and you can look, the data is logging here, 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 and if I reload, it will appear more data actually. Okay, so the next step is, if I cut the connection between both vNodes, what's going on with the data actually? Okay, so let's go here to vNode remote, and in this case, I'm going to go to the network adapter 2 under change adapters, and I will disable a local area connection. I'm going to disable the NIC adapter. Okay, it is disabled actually. And if you go again to the vNode and see real time, you will see that there's an uncertainty of quality of the data. The status is offline, okay? And actually, we stop looking for the data in real time, and also, it will stop looking for the data in historical, too. So if I make a reload here, remember that we already stopped here at 23, 21, 04, 045. stop the data collecting. I hit again reload. There's no more data updating here. And if you can see, there's 23, 21, 47 actually. 22, 21, 04 stopped collecting data, and now we have 23, 21, 58, 59, and we stopped to 23, 22, all right? Here, right now. So, if I again connect, reconnect in this case, my network adapter here, hit on enable. We are going to enable. Remember that it takes a little bit. Okay. Let's see. You will see here that in real time. Okay, that's working well. Let's go again to real time from local to see if the data has recovered. Actually, it's an uncertain too. Remember, it has some timeout that we have to cover. And for a while, the tag, in this case. So right now it's 23:25. Took a couple of minutes. All right. So right now, again, the connection is established, actually. You will see. And if we go here again to historical, we make some reload again. Remember that the whole information stopped logging here. And if you will see right now, 23:21, actually, is in which we stopped collecting data. And now you will see that those blanks are filled right now until 23:25, actually, that we reestablished the connection. So this big part here of data, actually, that you will see, has been collected on the buffer from the remote vNode, and once we reconnect the connection, actually the same data updated here in the local vNode too. So that's a big part of the information that we can collect and that we can back up and restore. And that's a big thing that we can, in this case, solve during a communication implementation too. So that's pretty much what we want to show you. If you need any assistance, any commercial question, or any support, please feel free to contact us at support@vnodeautomation.com, sales@vnodeautomation.com, or even info@vnodeautomation.com too. Thank you very much for your time today. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.